Okay, so to do this, I'm gonna assume that you've got this egg carton now full of eggs, the eggs being either zeros or occasionally a one. And what we need to do is take this info and stick it into a text file. So we're gonna make that text file in a Notepad. So if you go ahead and open that guy up. And the first thing that we have to do is make a header file. So let's just kinda boom, not 10, but let's start this off, header file, and it doesn't need to be bold. Okay, so the header file is gonna have a real strict syntax, and it starts with this thing n calls for number of columns, space, and then you enter in the number of columns, which I'm gonna let you guys figure out, but it's based on these guys, right? And then the next thing, so the important thing is after you've done the numbers there, don't have a space there. Make sure that it's just return. If you have a space here, you're gonna muck things up. So let's just have the number, and as soon as you're done with the number, hit the return or hit enter. And then the next guy is number of rows or n rows. No spaces in here, one space, and then you're gonna put numbers. And these are not numbers, right? You're gonna add numbers. I just don't wanna tell you. I want you to figure them out. And pretty straightforward. Here are your rows, so count them up. Okay, then there's this guy, which is XLL corner, which stands for the lower left corner x coordinate. And the hint is if you look at this guy on the bottom here, there are two numbers. One of these is an x coordinate, and one of these is a y coordinate. I'll let you figure out which one is which. The tricky part is that when you enter this number, you don't include the m. So all you're doing here is including a number. So there's going to be some number here, and I'm not going to tell you how many it is, but it's just going to be some number. And then YLL corner is going to be another number, and it's going to be essentially the y coordinate of that lower left corner. And after you've done that, you hit return. And again, there's no spaces after any of these numbers. The last thing is you're going to write cell size, all one word, space, and then you need to add the cell size, which is the length of this. You know, this is a pixel, and so you need the length of a single pixel, right? And I'm not going to tell you what that is. You're going to have to go figure it out. And there's your clue. Here's the image. You want to know what the length is of one of these things. Maybe what you do is you go try to start here, walk out about that far, figure out how many paces it is. Do you know the length of your paces? That kind of business. But I want you to kind of figure that out on your own. Then you're gonna, once you've figured that out, you're gonna hit return, and then you're gonna add a space. And I think it's actually important that there's a line here that's blank. And you're gonna start adding in your numbers. And this can be kind of fun because you're gonna, it kind of sounds like horseback riding, but you wanna go. And you're going to do that until you have a zero space zero. Each one of these is representing this, right? So the spaces are representing essentially the lines in between the two numbers. And you do that all the way to the end. And then when you get to the end, and again, I'm just doing this quickly, so you want to make sure that you have as many numbers here as you do columns here. But when you get to the very last one, you just hit return. It's really important that you don't have a space and then return. That's going to muck things up. So make sure you get to the last number and then have that cursor just blinking right on the side of that, whatever that number is. Hit return and you start over. And just gallop along. It's pretty fun. And make sure you throw in ones where it's appropriate. And eventually you're going to get a raster that's basically storing the values that you've penciled in here in this text file. And so it should have the number of columns and the number of rows that match this guy that you're transcribing. Fair enough. So when you're done, you want to save this as something. I saved mine as my first raster, even though it's not, but it might be yours. And you want to stick this in, I think, your home directory. So under Splinter, you should have a W drive that goes to your Splinter with your name on it. And then in here, you'll probably want to create a folder called GG120. And then under GG120, you might create a folder called Lab1. And under here, you can stick your first raster by saying save. And so just note that in these directories that I created when I named them, none of the names that I typed in have spaces in them. So that's even my first raster is just all one word. That's something that that's a tradition. This kind of the spaceless naming is a tradition that I'd like you to kind of begin to follow, if you would. Okay, so then if you've saved that, let's just finish this up. There was a header file. And then underneath that header file, there was, let's just call it a grid of values. And these two things are basically what compose the raster model. And let's move on.